One program in Flagler County is teaching women to fight back against crime. Today, we'll tell you how. Afternoon headlines are brought to you by Palm Coast Ford, your hometown dealer. Hello everyone, I'm Jared Malden with your afternoon headlines for Tuesday. Today's top story, class dismissed. Today, the Flagler County School Board searched for ways to shave money from its budget, and it could mean closing schools. $1.7 million needs to be shaved from the district budget if the proposed 0.5 mil property tax does not pass on June 7th. With open seats and declining enrollment, closing schools may be part of the answer. Mike Judd, Senior Director of School Operations, tossed around a couple of scenarios, including shutting down Old Kings or Wadsworth Elementary Schools, and potentially Indian Trails Middle School. Closing two schools would save the district about $1.8 million, but Judd did caution that the buildings would still need to be maintained to prevent them from turning into, quote, a mold experiment. Also discussed at the meeting, eliminating some paraprofessional positions, restructuring adult and community education classes, and extending bus transportation routes so that students who live 2 miles or less from the school would not have bus access. The cuts mentioned are just a few the district is discussing. For updates on this story and a more complete list, The Observer's Megan Hoy has this story online. The Flagler County Sheriff's Office is offering courses free of charge for women who want to educate themselves on self-defense. When it comes to protecting themselves against a would-be attacker, one thing's for sure. These ladies can fight. It's teaching skills with the hope they'll never need to be used. The Flagler County Sheriff's Office provides the women's self-defense classes free of charge. Women aged 12 and older are trained in not only how to avoid a possible crime, but also what defenses to use in case the worst occurs. Sergeant Mike Lutz started the program and believes the goal for the class is simple.
Hey, that's the goal of this class, is to get away from your attacker and to fight back.
And to increase that likelihood, the classes are broken down. Week one of the 3-week course, a PowerPoint presentation outlining safety issues. Weeks two and three, well, it's hands-on education.
It's very important for women especially to know, to empower them, to know that they can fight back, they can defend themselves. When you defend themselves, statistically it's been proven that your chance of survival or surviving an attack increased tremendously.
And to hit home just how important these classes are, more statistics. According to figures used by the Flagler County Sheriff's Office, every 2 seconds a crime occurs. Every 5 minutes, a woman is sexually assaulted in the U.S. 75% of the victims know their assailant. And possibly the most chilling stat of all, 84% of the crimes are never reported. Participants on the last week are given real-life scenarios where they must practice what has been preached.
We're going to teach you how to, you know, do strikes and different types of strikes and different parts of the body to strike, and a lot of different distractors to help you get away. It might be as simple as a pinch in the right spot, or, you know, using a pressure point in the right spot, or you have to do a nice hammer fist to the throat maybe.
And above all the different tactics, one important lesson.
And the number one thing, if you have to remember anything from this class, is to yell, scream, get attention. You need people to come and help you.
The women's self-defense classes are offered at various times throughout the year. If you or someone you know are interested in learning more, you can contact the Palm Coast Community Center at 986-2323.
This class, since 07, we've had over 80 classes, maybe 80 to 85 classes, with over 1,000 women that went through it.
Jared Malden, Palm Coast Observer. The Flagler County Sheriff's Office is also ready to settle in to a new Palm Coast precinct. A ribbon-cutting ceremony will be held this Friday at City Marketplace. The new location will mean the closing of the Old Kings location and will save the Sheriff's Office about $13,000 in rent. And those are your afternoon headlines for Tuesday. For news anytime, log on to our website at palmcoastobserver.com and like us on Facebook. I'm Jared Malden, and from everyone here at The Observer, thanks for watching.
Hi folks, Don York, General Manager of Palm Coast Ford, and I'd like to invite you down to check out Ford's all-new fuel-efficient lineup, like the all-new C-Max Energy. At Palm Coast Ford, go further for less. Palm Coast Ford, your hometown dealer.